Five decades after breaking the chains of colonialism, all across Nigeria and beyond, there is concern for the future of the country.
It's amazing, really, how the system has collapsed in this country.
For a period of 50 years, Nigeria has not gotten it right at all.
Many Nigerians believe things are worse than they were at independence.
From a minor departure, it widened into something which has become a disaster.
Today, Nigerians at all levels express profound dissatisfaction with the level of achievement of their leaders.
The reason why a young man like me would have left the UK to come back to Nigeria and be in politics is because I feel certain leaders may have failed us.
But the country's leadership has been seized by people who have no integrity.
They say there is widespread corruption, insecurity and poverty, and those in authority seem incapable of shouldering the demands of development.
The problem that we have here is majority of us in the leadership are bad.
You go to the ministry to do a simple task and somebody says, for your file to leave this desk, give me this.
The current administration of President Goodluck Jonathan is taking steps towards tackling corruption and revamping the economy.
We believe that it's possible for this economy to grow at double digits.
If we can sustain what we're doing about our democracy, built on the rule of law, I see a better tomorrow.
But the administration's inherited decades of mismanagement and decaying infrastructure.
We have a lot of youth on the street, they can't get jobs. Electricity is not working.
There's been a mass pauperization of the people.
And so, as Nigeria raises its flag in celebration 50 years after independence, the country is confronted with a socio-economic and political order that falls far short of expectations.
Whether military, which governed the country most of the years since independence, or democratic rule, which was intermittent, all agreed that there has been a failure of leadership.
The presidential election in 2011 offers a way out of Nigeria's political and economic quagmire. But only if the ballot is transparently and untypically free and fair, even as the country immerses itself in the most spectacular pre-election fever.
The natural resources we have, the human resources we have in this country, are such that if we have good leadership, the sky is the limit.
And as the feeling grows that change is possible, so does the sense that if the leaders continue to fail, then perhaps it's time for the followers to do something.
Let them come out massively, register and vote. Let us have over 60, 70, 80 million people coming out to say, no, enough is enough.
So the only way you can do it is like the Maoist cultural revolution. And people begin to say, listen, we could be better off than we are.
Coming up, as Nigeria marks 50 extraordinary years of independence, we examine the causes of the leadership crisis in the country. What forces have shaped post-colonial leadership in Nigeria? And to what extent can Nigeria's leaders be held accountable for the political, social, and economic problems that continue to besmirch the country?